Hello, Standard 9. Your Arun sir, and going to teach biology. It is chapter 5, pollination and fertilization, and this is part 1. Dear children, we have already started this topic in the offline classes, but unfortunately, the offline class was stopped and now only online classes are possible. So I am sending you video related to this topic. Okay. Pollination and fertilization, before that I will like to teach something. While you were in standard 8, I must have taught about the plants, 6 important parts of a plant I have taught, and these are root, stem, leaf, flower, fruit and seed. These 3, root, stem and leaf, are the vegetative part. They do not take part in reproduction, and flower, fruit and seed are the reproductive part. Very clear? These are the reproductive part. So if anyone asks you what is flower, your answer will start that it is the reproductive part of the plant. And here a little bit I will like to discuss about the flower. Okay. In standard 8 only, we have discussed complete flower and incomplete flower, unisexual flower and bisexual flower. So complete flower or bisexual flower, we have discussed. In these flower, all the 4 whorls, all 4 whorls are present. In complete flower, all the 4 whorls are present. Let us discuss about these 4 whorls. What are these 4 whorls? 4 whorls are, number 1, calyx, number 2, corolla, number 3, androecium, and number 4, gynoecium. We have already discussed in standard 8. Calyx is the outer whorl. It is green in color, and one unit is called as sepal. Okay, one unit is called as sepal. Whole chakra or whole whorl is called as calyx. One unit is called as sepal. It is green in color, does the work of photosynthesis and protects the flower in the bud stage. Next, corolla. It is the colored part, and one unit is called as petal, and the function is to attract the insects for pollination or protects the inner parts. So here we are not going to discuss these 2 things. What we are going to discuss, we are going to discuss about the androecium and gynoecium. Androecium, it is the male part, and symbol of male you are knowing, male. And gynoecium is the female part. Okay, and symbol of female you are knowing. Androecium is the male part and gynoecium is the female part. And one unit of androecium, what it is called? Do you remember?
Yes.
One unit of androecium is called as stamen. And one unit of gynoecium is called as carpel or pistil. Very clear? So one unit of androecium, the male part, is called as a stamen, and one unit of gynoecium, the female part, is called as carpel or pistil. Now let us discuss in detail about the stamen and the pistil or carpel. Okay, see here, androecium, one unit is stamen. Let me draw a diagram showing stamen. Okay, this is what? Filament. And this is anther. Very clear? And this anther is two-lobed. Anther is two-lobed. And in each lobe, two chambers are there. So total four chambers are there in the anther. And these chambers are like this. And if we will cut it, we will get like this. Very clear? And in this, yellow powdery materials are kept. Yellow powdery material. Do you know what are these yellow powdery material? If you are seeing the anther, yes, they are the pollen grains. What they are? Pollen grains. And actually, pollen grains are the male gamete or male sex cell or sperm. These pollen grains are the male gamete, male sex cell, or you can call it sperm. So male gamete is present in this anther. Very clear? And coming to the gynoecium. Gynoecium is the female part of the flower, female whorl, and one unit is called as carpel or pistil. Let us see how it looks. It looks like this. Nothing new I am teaching. The old one which I have taught, that only revising. See here. This is stigma, style, and ovary. And ovary contains ovules. And do you know what are ovules? Ovules are the female gamete. Okay. Ovules are the female gamete or female sex cell. So this part is clear, that this is the male part and this is the female part. One unit of androecium is called as stamen. One unit of gynoecium is called as pistil or carpel. In stamen, filament and anther are there, and anther contains the male gamete or the male sex cell or sperm, that is called as pollen grain. And gynoecium, female part, female whorl, one unit is called as pistil or carpel. And in pistil, stigma, style, and ovary is there. And ovary contains the female gamete or female sex cell, and that is called as ovules. These parts are clear. A little bit I will like to discuss about the reproduction. All living beings reproduce, means produce their own children. Okay. We are the son and daughter of our father. our father and mother, they are the son or daughter of grandfather. You are the son and daughter of ours. So, and this will continue throughout the life. Means it is one of the characteristic of a living being, whether plant or animal, they will have their babies. And reproduction is of two type. One is asexual and other is sexual. In asexual reproduction, single individual is capable of producing offspring or a baby. For example, if you are cutting a stem of a rose plant and planting it, it will grow into a new rose plant. What type of reproduction is that? Their male and female is not required. Whether male or female, they are capable of producing a child or baby. That type of reproduction is called as asexual. And sexual reproduction, here male and female gametes are required. Okay, male and female gametes are required. Male produces male gamete or a sperm or male sex cell, and female produces female gamete or female sex cell or egg, and both fuses together, meets together, and after meeting they form a single cell, and the name of the single cell is zygote. Very clear? Single cell is the zygote, and zygotes divide to form embryo. Embryo will develop to form a baby or a child. So we, our life also starts from a single cell, and the single cell is the zygote, single cell, and this single cell is formed by the fusion of male and female gamete. So a process in which there is fusion of male and female gamete is called as fertilization. Very clear? So for sexual reproduction, fertilization is necessary. But in plants, for fertilization, the male gamete should reach to the female gamete, and the male gamete should reach to the female gamete for the fertilization. Now, this male gamete is carried to the female gamete, means there is transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma. Okay, so transfer of pollen grain from where? From anther to the stigma of a flower of same species is called pollination. Understood or not? This male gamete means pollen grain must be transferred to the female gamete, and this transfer of male gamete of a flower to the female gamete of a flower is called as pollination. Very clear? So we are going to discuss in detail about pollination, and when the male and female gamete will meet, fertilization will take place and zygote will be formed. So the name of the chapter is pollination and fertilization. Now one more thing, the species of the plant must be same. If male gamete of a mango plant is falling on the female gamete of a guava plant, no fertilization will take place. So a species must be same, then only pollination will take place. So dear children, what is pollination? We have understood. Okay, and I am sure you have learnt also. Now coming to the certain terms related to pollination, which is very, very important, and which we have to learn. Okay, certain terms related to pollination. What are those terms which we have to learn? First term is autogamy. Auto means knowing, self, automatic, auto start, automobile, auto, self, and gamus, the word gamus means marriage, self marriage means individual is marrying to himself or herself. That type of that is called autogamy. Means what? If the flower is bisexual, bisexual flower means male and female gamete both are present, male part and female part both are present in the same flower. Can you say any example? Yes, hibiscus, or that is called China rose. In that male and female both parts are there, and if from the male part the pollen grain is falling on the female part, pollination will take place, and that type of pollination is called as autogamy. Very clear or not? Okay, means from the anther, pollen from the anther will fall on the stigma of the same flower, then that type of pollination is called as autogamy. Next, so autogamy we have understood. Next is gynogamy. Gamy means marriage, and gytno means neighboring. The pollen of another flower of same plant. Pollen of another flower of same plant falls on stigma of the flower. Now try to understand gynogamy. This is a plant, okay, and here is one flower, here is one flower, many flowers are there, but one flower is male flower and other is female flower. In one plant only some flowers are male and some flowers are female. We have discussed now in standard 8 monocots and diocots. And one example is maize. Maize. Okay. Some flowers are male and some flowers are female. And if pollen grain from the anther falls on the stigma of one flower to another flower of the same plant, then that is called as gynogamy. So gynogamy understood. Next, coming to allogamy. Allogamy. Try to understand. This is a plant, it bears flower, and this is what? Male plant, and here female, and from one plant the transfer of pollen grain is taking place to flower of the other plant, then such type of pollination is called as allogamy, but the species must be same. Very clear or not? A species must be same. This is also mango plant and this is also mango, but they are far from each other, they are far from each other, and by any of the medium this pollen grain is falling on the stigma of the flower of the same species, but the plant is far from that plant, then that type of pollination is called as allogamy. So dear children, this part is clear. Now we have discussed about what is pollination, what is fertilization, what is autogamy, what is gynogamy, what is allogamy. Now, kinds of pollination. Okay. Kinds of pollination. There are two kinds of pollination. One is self-pollination and other is cross-pollination. And when self-pollination will take place? When the flower is bisexual. Bisexual means male and female both part are present and they are matured at the same time. Then this self-pollination will take place. There are certain plants which bear either male flower or female flower. Papaya. Some papaya plant only bear male flower and some papaya plants only bear female flower. Okay. Then only cross pollination is possible. Okay. Their self pollination is not possible. So what is self pollination and what is cross pollination we have understood. Now when can self pollination take place? If the flower is bisexual, when self-pollination is possible, self-pollination is possible if the flower is bisexual. Second is homogamy. Let us discuss about the bisexual. We are knowing that male and female both parts are present. And homogamy, anther and stigma of a flower must mature at the same time. Anther and stigma matures at the same time, then only this self-pollination is possible. So dear children, we have understood this. In the next video, we will discuss advantages and disadvantages of self-pollination and cross-pollination. Today up to this much. In the next video, the rest part. Thank you very much.